learn how to make French press coffee. So you're gonna need a French press. And I've got a couple of them, but I wanted to show you this one because it's so affordable. Last time I was in Atlanta, I picked it up for less than $20, and I love it. So you just wanna open up your French press. Notice we've got all the French stuff going on today. And I'm going to take some coffee, which I ran through my coffee grinder. So it's really fine. Not super fine, it's medium actually. And this is a spoon that I use for coffee every day. So I do a heaping spoon of this, and it's equal to 2 tablespoons of coffee. That might be a little bit strong for you guys, but I've been drinking coffee since, well, let's just say 5 decades. And so I like it strong. The other thing that I add every day is a little bit of cinnamon. So I'm gonna just do a couple of shakes of that. You can also add cardamom seeds, nutmeg if you want. Just, you know, get creative with your coffee flavors. And now this is ready to go, you can see. And I'm gonna pour over the boiling water. So excuse me a second. My husband got me this nice electric tea kettle, and it actually has a French drip button on it. And that means that it brings the water up to a 200 degree temp. And that's what you need for coffee, for a French press coffee. And it actually says French press on the machine. So now I'm just going to put the lid on. I'm not pressing down. And we're gonna let this sit for 7 minutes. That seems to be the magical time for it to brew. And then I'll show you what it looks like. So I know some of you are out there wondering, why am I not with the program? Why don't I have a Keurig? I've had a Keurig. I've had lots of coffee machines. So let me tell you what happened. I guess maybe 3 or 4 years ago, a hurricane came through the Gulf Coast and knocked out our power. And so I had to pull out my trusty French press pot. And luckily we have gas in this house, so I was able to boil water and started making coffee that way until the power came back on. Oh my gosh, I had forgotten just how good this French press coffee is. And you know, then I thought about too, all of the waste that's attached to using a Keurig, and you know, the plastic that you're exposing yourself to every time you brew a cup of coffee. And I thought, you know, I'm just gonna make this a ritual. I get up in the morning, put the kettle on to boil. Sometimes I play a game with myself. How much can I get done in 7 minutes while this coffee is brewing? And I'll go around and maybe water all my plants or take my dogs out or do something and come back and enjoy my first cup of coffee. So yes, I'm fully aware that there's a lot of great coffee makers out there, but I'll challenge you to give this a try because the taste is just incredible. So let me check perfect timing. This is ready to go. So now what I'm going to do is just slowly press it down. And I've seen some people will stir up the coffee grounds before they put the top on. I don't do any of that. So let's see how this looks. There you go. Nice, beautiful brown color. There's nothing worse to me than weak coffee where it's really, really translucent looking. So this looks beautiful. And now, let me just bring it closer so you can see that gorgeous brown color. And you're like, well, what if I don't drink the whole pot? You can actually reheat it. So I just put it in the microwave. and reheat it. You can also use it in smoothies. You can also, once it's cooled off, pour it into an ice tray and freeze it for iced coffee later. So there's a lot of good uses for your coffee. Now, if you want to get a little fancy, I love using heavy cream in my coffee. And honestly, most mornings I'll just pour it in. But you can froth too at home. So just pour it in a cup, or if you have a metal cup, that's even better. Ooh. Picked this up on Amazon for, I don't know, $15 maybe. So watch what happens. You'll get that beautiful froth, and you can make this as thick as you want it. It's just that easy. And hey, I love a good coffee shop as much as anybody. However, you know, I drink coffee every day, and I'm certainly not going to go and spend $5 or $7 for coffee, a cup of coffee every day. That would be insane. So you just pour this over. And you can add your favorite sweetener. You can a couple of drops of stevia, sugar if you're still using sugar. But there it is. That is the perfect French press cup of coffee. So here is your perfect. I want to tilt it in so you can see it. French press coffee, topped with some whipped cream that you've done yourself. So thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Thanks to all my subscribers. I love cooking with all of y'all, and I just want to make it easy. I don't want you to ever be afraid to try things in the kitchen. And put some comments below. What do you want to learn how to make? And I will surely take up the challenge.